Welcome to Comet. I'm Gretel from Customer Success, and in this video, I will show you how to get your backups up and running in a few easy steps. Let's get started. This is the Comet Management Console, where you will be able to centrally manage all of your storage and backup configurations, as well as all of your devices and users. This can be either self-hosted or Comet-hosted. Follow the link to our product page below for more information on these options. Let us first configure a storage template, which will allow us to easily request a storage vault for our users. This is set up in the Management Console. Go to Settings, then Storage Template. As you can see, there will be a ready storage template where you can configure your storage. On Comet Hosted, this will be pre-configured with Comet Storage. On Self-Hosted, this will be pointing to Storage Gateway, which supports on-prem storage. We have linked a guide below on how to configure on-prem storage through Storage Gateway. First, click on Toggle Default to set this as your default storage template. Then, click on Edit. Select your storage type here. If your storage type is not among these options, it is not supported as a storage template. You will then have to manually add this storage type as a storage vault. We will cover how to add a storage vault later in this video. For this video, I will configure a template for Comet Storage. Enter the information asked for and click on Test Connection. Finally, I will rename the storage template and click on Save. And you can now easily request a storage vault from the storage template. Next, let us create a user. In this video, we will create a single user. However, it is possible to set up multiple users. Add the username here and set a password. A storage vault will be created once a device is registered to this user. This will be requested from the default storage that we had configured earlier. Click on Add User after you have configured your settings. Next, we will download and install the Comet Backup Agent on a device. You can download the installer here. An installer is available for Windows, macOS, Linux, and Synology. After downloading, extract and launch the installer. Follow the prompt until the installation is complete. And the agent is now installed on the device. Now, we need to log in to the agent. We will log in with the user profile that we had created earlier in the Management Console. Here, register your device to the user profile. Once the device is registered, you can start remotely managing it from the Management Console. Now, let us go through the steps to manually configure a storage vault. As you will recall, a storage vault has already been requested from the storage template that we configured earlier. If your storage type cannot be configured as a storage template, it will have to be manually configured as a storage vault. Make sure to add a storage vault before setting up a protected item schedule. Here, click on Add New Vault. You can rename your storage vault here. Click on the plus sign to choose your storage type. As you can see here, you can configure a wide variety of storage types with Comet. In this example, I will set up an S3-compatible storage vault. Fill in the required fields and click on Test Connection. Click on Save after configuring the storage. And we now have our S3-compatible storage set up as a storage vault. We can now set up a protected item or a backup type on the endpoint. To configure a backup, go to the Protected Items tab. Click on Add Protected Item. These are the protected items or backup types that you can configure with Comet. I will set up a file and folder backup. Select the items to backup here. When setting up a file and folder backup, you can browse the contents of a registered device as long as the device is online. Click on Next after making your selection. Click on the plus sign here to configure a backup schedule. Click on this plus sign to add your schedule. There are several schedule types to choose from. I will set up a daily backup. This backup will be directed to this storage vault. Click on Save. We now have a file and folder backup that will run daily. We are now ready to start a backup. We have already configured a schedule for this file and folder backup. However, we can also run a backup manually either in the Devices tab or in the Protected Items tab. Click on Run Backup here. Make sure you are pointing to the storage vault you would like to backup to, and click on Backup. The backup is now running. We are going to check on the job status next. In the Protected Items tab, you will see the status of the last backup job. As you can see, our backup ran successfully. You can click on the date here to access the job log. You can export the job log here. And you will see the files that were backed up in the Files tab. You can also access logs across all users in the Job Log section. Click on Job Search to pull up the logs that you're after. In this case, I am searching for job logs for the user that we created. And here is the log for the backup we just ran. Before we end the video, let us have a quick look at how you can initiate a restore of your backups. To restore backups to a device, that device must have the Comet agent installed and it must be logged in to the same user that you are restoring from. To start the restore process from your Comet Management Console, go to the Devices tab and click on Actions beside the device that you are restoring to. Click on Restore. Make sure you are pointing to the storage vault with the backups to restore. You will be able to see all backups within the storage vault from other devices. Choose the snapshot to restore and follow the restore wizard. And those are the basic steps to run and restore a backup with Comet. We have linked related process guides below for more information. If you have any questions at all, email us at hello@cometbackup.com and we'll be happy to help.